During some flood events, the extent and location of inundation may be the most important variable for decision support services. This service provides visualizations for the current analysis, medium range forecasts covering 3, 5, and 10 day periods, and an 18 hour short range forecast. Maximum inundation extent is the resulting riverine induced flooding from the maximum forecast stream flow along each river segment. At present, the National Water Model and the associated inundation extent forecasts do not account for coastal processes like storm surge, and as such should be used with caution along the coastal fringe. These visualizations are most useful when zoomed into an area of interest and used with complementary services such as maximum high flow magnitude. Inundation is determined using the height above the nearest drainage, or hand method. Inundation occurs when the height of water in a stream exceeds its banks. Surface inundation can be mapped using the knowledge of which surface locations have lower elevation than the stream's height.
The National Water Model estimated high water threshold is defined with an annual exceedance probability, or AEP, which is inversely related to the average return interval, or ARI. These values were derived using a statistical analysis of flow for each river reach location over the multi-decadal National Water Model climatology.
Information about potential inundation associated with high flows provides vital decision support. With the information, our partners and forecast users can make decisions about road closures, evacuations, sandbagging, and assistance to vulnerable populations.
Many streams were highlighted on the maximum high flow magnitude visualization during Hurricane Michael. We can zoom in on these areas of concern to see the associated inundation forecast. The blue shading shows model predictions of the maximum extent of riverine-induced flooding from nearby streams. This service shows aerial extent of inundation, but at this time does not provide details about flood depth. Clicking an inundation polygon reveals additional details, including the maximum flow and stage in the nearby stream.
When used with authoritative datasets and other prepared map layers, we can see where inundation may impact roads, buildings, and other critical infrastructure, as well as vulnerable populations. In the medium range, this information is vital for effective decision support planning activities for potential hazards. In the short range, this information supports detailed warnings and life-saving actions.
The maximum inundation extent visualizations provide relatable information about where riverine-induced flooding is occurring or forecast. For forecasters, this is a very useful tool, especially when combined with other data services from the National Water Model.